Hello everyone, welcome back to Amazing Smart, the channel where we explore clever tips, fun experiments, and creative ideas for everyday life. Today, I'm bringing you a truly unique experience. How to revive a car key that has run out of battery using simple items you can easily find right in your kitchen. The story begins with a familiar situation. You're about to head out, holding your car remote in hand, pressing the button to unlock the door, but nothing happens. The light doesn't flash, the car doesn't open, and you quickly realize that the battery inside the key has completely died. Step 1. Prepare the tools to deal with this situation. The first thing we need to do is get a small toolkit to remove the battery from the key. This could be as simple as a small screwdriver, a thin knife, or a specialized tool to open the key cover. When removing the battery, be careful not to break the plastic clips or damage the internal circuit. Once the cover is open, you'll see a small button cell battery, usually a CR2032 or something similar. Step 2. Test the battery with a multimeter next. We'll use a multimeter to check the battery's current. This is an important step to confirm its actual condition. Set the multimeter to DC voltage mode. Touch the red probe to the positive side and the black probe to the negative side of the battery. The reading on the screen will tell you whether the battery still has power. In this case, the multimeter shows zero voltage, meaning the battery is completely drained. Step 3. Experiment with a lemon. Instead of throwing it away and buying a new one, let's try a fascinating trick. Grab a fresh lemon from the kitchen. First, cut the lemon in half with a knife. Then, carve out a small portion of the pulp to make space next. Sprinkle a little salt inside the lemon. The salt helps increase conductivity when combined with citric acid. Step 4. Place the battery inside the lemon now. Comes the fun part. Place the battery between the two halves of the lemon. Put the battery into one half. Then press the other half on top so the battery sits snugly inside. At this point, the lemon acts like a natural charger. The citric acid and salt create an electrochemical environment that stimulates and partially restores energy to the battery. Step 5. Wait for a while after closing the lemon. Leave the battery inside for a certain period, about 15 to 30 minutes. While waiting, you'll feel a bit excited, as if you're conducting a science experiment right at home. Step 6. Clean and treat the battery. Once you remove the battery from the lemon, its surface will be damp and may have acid residue. The next step is to clean it with WD-40. WD-40 not only removes dirt, but also protects the metal surface from oxidation. Spray a thin layer of WD-40 onto the battery. Wipe it clean with a tissue. Then, rinse with clean water to remove any remaining lemon acid. Step 7. Dry the battery with a heat gun tow. Ensure the battery is completely dry. Use a heat gun or a hairdryer. Blow warm air evenly around the battery for a few minutes until the surface is dry. Step 8. Test again with the multimeter now. It's time to check the results. Place the battery on the multimeter once more. This time, you'll see a voltage reading, proof that the battery has been partially revived. Step 9. Reinstall the battery into the key. Finally, put the battery back into the car key. Close the cover, press the unlock button, and amazingly, the key works again. Conclusion: so, we've gone through a fun journey, discovering the dead battery, testing it with a multimeter, experimenting with a lemon, cleaning with WD-40, drying with heat, and ultimately reviving the battery successfully. This isn't just a handy trick. It's also a fun scientific experiment that helps you understand more about how electrochemistry works in everyday life. Thank you so much for watching today's video. If you found this content useful and entertaining, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Amazing Smart to support us. See you again in the next video.